Welcome to Engineering Python. This is the Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I'll talk about MatPlotLib subplots, GridSpec, and access. Before we start, we need to turn on the Jupyter Notebook renderer so we can see all the plotting results in this browser. We need to import pyplot as plt. We also need to import numpy as np. Next, we create the data arrays we will use in this video. X contains 15 points evenly distributed between negative pi and positive pi. C contains the cosine values of X. S contains the sine values of X. They both have the same shape as X. After all these preparations, let's create a figure. The size is 5 inches by 4 inches. The DPI is 80. Using this subplot function, we will create some basic plotting units called axes. The number of rows is 2, the number of columns is 1. It will create a total of 2 times 1 equals 2 axes in the figure window. The last one is the index. It means we are currently doing the plotting in the first axis. Next, we plot the cosine curve in this axis. The second subplot refers to the second axis. We plot the sine curve in this axis. Finally, we show the figure. The result is in figure 1. We can also create horizontally placed axes using subplot. In this subplot function, the number of rows is 1, and the number of columns is 2. In the first axis, we plot the cosine curve. In the second axis, we plot the sine curve. Also, we can use a grid function to control whether we need to show the grid. A string off, we turn off the grid. On, we turn it on. In this example, we turn the grid in the left axis off and turn the grid in the right axis on. Next, we create 4 axes using the subplot function. 2 rows and 2 columns. In the first axis, we plot the cosine function. This string specifies the line color, the line style, and the marker. B means blue. The dash means a solid line. The star means the data points will be marked by stars. In the second axis, we plot the sine function. R means red. We didn't define the line style. That means we should not connect these dots with any lines. S means the data points will be marked by squares. In the third axis, we plot the negative cosine function. G means green. The double dashes mean the dashed line. V means the data points will be marked by triangles. In the fourth axis, we plot the negative sine function. M means magenta. The colon means the dotted line. O means the data points will be marked by circles. The result is shown in figure 3. Now let's talk about GridSpec. GridSpec can create a subplot across multiple cells. It can be illustrated using this image. We have a total of 9 cells, 3 rows and 3 columns. Remember, in Python, indexes start from 0 if we count in ascending order. This is the 0th row, this is the 1st row, this is the 2nd row. If we count backwards, the indexes start from negative 1. So this index is negative 1, this is negative 2, and this is negative 3. The same rules apply to the column indexes. In the code, we need to import the GridSpec submodule from MatPlotLib. Then we create a figure and define a grid using the GridSpec class in the GridSpec module. The grid contains 3 rows and 3 columns, like what we showed here. The name of this object is GS. We create the first axis using the subplot function in the 0th row and all the columns. In this axis, we plot the cosine function. We create the second axis in the 1st row and all the columns, except the last one. In this axis, we plot the sine function. We create the third axis in the last row and the 0th column. In this axis, we plot the negative cosine function. we create the fourth axis in row number negative 1 and column number negative 2. In this axis, we plot the negative sine function. We create the fifth axis in the first and second rows and the last column. In this axis, we plot the sum of cosine and sine divided by 2. Axis is the most basic and most flexible unit for creating subplots. It allows placement of plots at any location in the figure. In this example, we use the axis function to create the first axis. The argument is a list of 4 elements. This 0.1 means the distance between the left side of this axis to the left border of the figure window is 10% of the total width of the figure window. This 0.1 means the distance between the bottom side of this axis to the bottom border of the figure window is 10% of the total height of the figure window. This 0.8 means the width of the axis from the left to the right is 80% of the total width of the figure window. This 0.8 means the height of the axis from the bottom to the top is 80% of the total height of the figure window. In this large axis, we plot the sine function. Next, we use the axis function to create the second axis. It takes another list of 4 elements. This 0.2 means the distance between the left side of this axis to the left border of the figure window is 20% of the total width of the figure window. This 0.6 means the distance between the bottom side of this axis to the bottom border of the figure window is 60% of the total height of the figure window. This 0.3 means the width of the axis from the left to the right is 30% of the total width of the figure window. This 0.3 means the height of the axis from the bottom to the top is 30% of the total height of the figure window. In this small axis, we plot the cosine function. The figure is shown in figure 5. Okay, that was about MatPlotLib, subplots, GridSpec, and axis. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.